Philippine President Marcos Jr. directs his incoming education chief, Sonny Angara, to improve the welfare of teachers and to make the country's basic education system more responsive to the needs of the labor market. We have this report. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. looking to institute a few changes to the K-12 program, as he noted that it has failed to adequately prepare students with the skills needed for employment after graduation.
Ginawa natin yung K-12 dahil hinahanap ang years of training sa ating mga nag-a-apply. At sinasabi dito sa Pilipinas, kulang dahil 10 years lang. That was the reason we did it, para employable yung mga graduate natin. Pero kung titignan natin, ang naging resulta, hindi gumanda ang employability nila. So we have to do something else.
The Philippine leader says he has directed incoming Education Secretary Sonny Angara to focus on improving the employability of Filipino students, such as the possible inclusion of short-term courses that will allow students to have specializations.
We were examining things like mini courses, yung mga 3 buwan, 6 na buwan, 1 year short courses para sa mga specialty. But we have to coordinate with the private sector so that the private sector will have also be able to have a guaranteed supply of skilled workers that will be coming into their own industries. So yung ganong klaseng coordination ay importante. Dahil kuminsan meron tayong mga livelihood project na turuan nga ng livelihood pero wala naman trabaho pa rin.
Marcos Jr. says he has also directed Angara to address the poor performance of Filipino students, particularly in STEM, or science, technology, engineering, and mathematics subjects, as shown in recent international assessment examinations. An earlier study by the Program for International Student Assessment, or PISA, showed that Filipino students were among the lowest scorers in reading, math, and science.
We go back to make sure that everybody understands the basics, because marami pang hindi nasa grade 5 na, nasa grade 6 na, mahina pagbasa, mabagal. At saka yung mga simple na mathematics na exam, hindi nila kayang gawin. So yun ang kailangan talaga, basics. We have to go back to basics.
This, he says, also includes teaching Philippine history to the youth.
One thing I asked of him was to please teach our children Philippine history, because I have seen my children's workbooks and there's very little said about the history of the Philippines. Ito ang pinagdaanan ng aming lahi. Kaya kami nandito, kaya ganito kami, kaya ganyan ang ugali namin dahil sa aming kasaysayan.
Marcos also wants Angara to prioritize the welfare of Filipino teachers, especially in ensuring that they have enough salaries to sustain themselves and their families, and that they continuously undergo training to help them cope with the rapid changes in technology. In an interview, Angara said he is ready to take on the challenges as education chief.
I have relationships also with people in Congress, relationships built up over the years that may come in handy when it comes to time for the budget and asking, lobbying for certain policies for the department. I think there's a lot of opportunities here in collaboration with a lot of well-meaning individuals and organizations, opportunity with using technology to jumpstart the traditional methods and of learning. You know, we're in the age of AI, so maybe catching up will be easier because of the opportunities provided by artificial intelligence.
Angara also vows to address traditional gaps in the sector, as well as to bring an innovative and collaborative approach to education. For now, he is working on a smooth transition in the leadership in the Department of Education, as well as in ensuring the smooth opening of classes.